Welcome to RyeCoach.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to configure working days in Jira. Generally, when we are working into any particular projects, we will always require to configure working days. Let's say we have weekends or any holidays in between our sprint. So this will create a difference in between our working hours or targeted working hours. So generally, these working days, so whatever working days are remaining into the particular stream, that will be highlighted here. So we'll see here how to configure working days and non-working days into any particular active sprint or for all of our projects. So if you're new to this channel and want to learn a Jira complete from scratch to expert level, then please follow the channel. And if you're visiting this channel first time, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Now, for configuration point of view, we have to navigate into the board or board settings. For navigating into the board settings, we have to select the three dots and click on board settings. And from working days, we have the options here for configurations. So generally, the person who is having business level permissions or scrum master or project manager is a person who will be able to edit this configuration page. Otherwise, junior candidates or the junior team members won't be able to access this page. So on the board settings, we have to select the time zone. So just this is a region specific. If we are working into US region, then we have to select US. If you are working into the Asian region, we have to select the Asia or Atlantic or Australia or Europe. Totally depending on your project's locations or base location, we have to select this region. Then time zone is very important part. Generally, these are the days or the working days which will be highlighted in the report section as well. So if this is not properly configured, definitely we'll get a difference in data or in report. So time zone, based on your project time zone, we have to select it accordingly. So by default, this is Chicago, but if you want, let's consider Asian time zone, select as per your Asian standard. So let's say we are working into the Qatar. So Qatar is generally having a standard working days of Thursday and Friday holiday. So here we have to configure in such a way, like whenever we will not select these two options, it means these are the declared holiday for any organization. So it means we have 5 days working structure, but Saturday and Sunday will be working for the Qatar and UAE region, and Thursday and Friday is holiday. Generally, this consider on the local region. If we have the 6 days working culture, definitely, let's say if you are working into 6 days working culture, we'll select according to the holidays list. Generally, I am going ahead with this considering like Thursday and Friday will be holiday. So this will create 5 days working structure. Now, if we have any additional vacations or any additional holiday in between our sprint, then we have to select it accordingly. So let's consider 26 will be holiday. So generally 26 will be holiday. It means our team will not work in this day. So declaration is very much important. If we are not declaring, it means it will be calculated into our capacity planning as well. So here, if we have the holiday, it means in a complete sprint where the sprint size will be 2 weeks, it means total 10 working days if we have 5 days working structure. So if we are including one more day, it means we are just getting 9 days for the working. So this here we are configuring non-working days in terms of additional holiday, but here we are just doing the configurations on the weekly standard. So this will be calculated on our complete project, or this will be applied into our complete project. So this is how we are doing the configuration. And once we are done, just go back to our sprint and you'll see the impact will be ready. And when we'll generate a report, these holiday will be counted over there. Again, if you want to edit it, go back and keep the previous structure, like we have the Saturday and Sunday holiday in Asian region. Now we are keeping in that structure, but totally depending on our requirement, we may set it up as per our required detail. So that's all how we are editing or updating working days and non-working days in Jira board, which will be applied to any particular project. So if we are working in this project, the settings will be applied to this project only. If we are working into any other projects, so we have to set it up on the board level, because this is a board level setting. If we are doing the global settings, that configurations will be different. So we'll see in the next part of the video. Hope this cleared your doubts in Jira working and non-working days settings. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.